you something. You'll remember Jennifer said it, but I've got it over here. If I show you a picture, chances are you'll remember 40%. If I tell you a story, you will connect in a different way.
What am I doing?
Too close to the speaker. You will connect with it emotionally, like at conference when Elder Bednar tells about the truck. I mean, bing, you've got that whole recollection because of the truck. But if you memorize words and music together, they will stay with you. I like to just say forever, because it's like 90%. We had over at the rehab ranch where my husband was the ranch president, we had a woman with Alzheimer's. And Phyllis, you talked to her and she would say words but nothing made any sense, and no two words went together. But we'd bring her to Relief Society and we'd sit her out in the hall kind of, because she did talk a lot and quite loud. But most interestingly, whenever we started to sing, there was Phyllis, both hands going, leading the singing and singing every word of every hymn. So you knew somewhere in her past she had been involved in music, because it was there. It was tucked away in between all of that forgetfulness that she was experiencing. So she was still inside. Now, Sister Smith, oh my goodness. You know what was going on when Joseph received the vision, the inspiration that Heavenly Father wanted us to have a handbook in the church. It took him 5 years to gather the texts. Oh, I forgot to bring one. To gather the texts and put them into the little tiny pocketbook that has words only. And she knew a good hymn when she saw one, because we still sing many that are in that book. But the reason that it was so important is that my soul delighteth in the song of the heart, yea, the song of the righteous is a prayer unto me. You know that. You should memorize that. You should be able to just say that to the children, that they are giving a prayer when they sing. But this part you probably don't say as much. And it shall be answered with a blessing upon their heads. Well, what blessing do you have because of your music? What blessing do you give to the children through the music? This is what you should think about. How is it blessing your life? I find it very invigorating. You know, I was exhausted last night trying to pack all this stuff. But here I am. I'm all wide awake. You know, there's something rejuvenating about the music. And it should do that for the children, too, through your enthusiasm. Now, when I was called to primary, it was 1980. We'd just gone on a consolidated schedule. I got a phone call asking if I would come down to the general primary offices, and I thought, oh no, I am in trouble. I have published my little songs that I had written for junior Sunday school. No, none of you know even what that is. Junior Sunday school for children 3 years old. How old? Nursery to 7. Get it right. So I had been in there for 10 years doing a program for Christmas, Mother's Day, Father's Day, and sometimes we did it before 4th of July, because I thought the children should have an opportunity to speak and be up in front, and my bishop had asked me to do it. So for 10 years, I'd used the same Christmas songs, you know, over and over, the same Mother's Day. So I started, and it wasn't on purpose, I don't know how this happened, but I started writing songs for my little children in junior Sunday school. So 1 year, our Christmas program, I got this great idea. I thought, why don't we have a great big picture frame? And I didn't bring these visuals, but I will have somebody tell about Christmas memories, the way they picture Christmas. And we'll have them stand in the picture frame with a microphone and tell what they remember. So, well, when you get a program idea going, you need to have a clincher at the end. So then I wrote a song to go with it. And I'm sure that you've probably seen Picture Christmas, which ended up in the children's songbook. Well, when I first wrote it, it had different words. I wrote, picture Christmas without children, picture a snowstorm without snow, and could you see a Christmas tree with not one gift below? There is no Christmas without children, and it's the same. Well, when I was called in primary, one of the first assignments, oh, I have to tell you this other part. Sister Young, I thought they were going to tell me that I better quit writing songs because they weren't approved and people were using them in primary and I was in trouble, all of that. Anyway, that wasn't what they called me for. She wanted to know if I would be willing to serve on the primary general board. I said, I just went to the doctor and I'm expecting my sixth child. I don't know if I can do what you need me to do. And she said, oh, we can work around a baby. So, did that happen when you had your baby? Don't they release you usually? Okay, so my first assignment was sharing time. We didn't have a sharing time then. We had a new block on Sunday, and people needed to fill it up, and everybody was scared to death because in primary it said, now say this, now say this, now say this. And here we had this time, and you were supposed to figure it out what to teach. So I had the opportunity to work with the Friend magazine, which I loved, because it was the kind of thing that I did as a school teacher where I did visuals. You know, I made a picture of something and then I held it up and had the children. Where's my mother's day one? Oh. In fact, here's my grandmother's song, and I've got visuals all the way around it because those are the things you sing about. Having a grandmother to love you is better than the frosting on the cake. Anyway, we just went around. Anyway, so that was my opportunity, and I did it for 8 years. Every month, I wrote something for the Friend magazine because I could do that at home. So that was nice. Then the baby came, and my mother started attending, and I was asked to write a song to go for the new curriculum that was being written for the Star Age children. So I knew what needed to be included in the message of the song, that we know Heavenly Father loves us, and we should be happy. So I asked my little Matt to come. This is Matt. He now has 3 children. The youngest one is this age. So I asked Matt to come to the piano, and I said, what's your favorite song?
So, of course,
at the piano with my son. I had a purpose. I knew that it was for little children, and it just sort of flowed together. Well, that song, if you think, well, they say you don't get paid for serving in the church. I have been richly paid. That little song has been such a blessing. Through that song, even little tiny children have been able to feel the Spirit. I went to Bloomington, Indiana, and gave a music workshop, and because I was there, the music leader had the children sing this for me. And as they sang, at the end, he just sort of stood there, this little man, and he said, boys and girls, did you feel that? That was the Spirit of Heavenly Father. You sounded like angels. That was the first time I'd ever heard somebody identify that feeling for the children. And I was so impressed with it that I watched for that from then on, whenever music was being sung by children. Because if I could feel it, certainly they were feeling it, but they may not know. So you need to identify to them what they're feeling. There was a woman in Idaho who was an EMT. If you were here before I've said all this, I'm sorry. But it's my lead. Anyway, she was called out to help with an accident. A family had been injured and they'd been in a van. And she was assigned to help a little 4-year-old boy. And on her way there, she prayed that she would know how to help. And when she got there, this little boy was just flailing all around, and she was needing him to hold still so she could put him on one of those little board things and get him in the ambulance, and he wouldn't lay still. So she started singing, I am like a star to me. And as she sang, he relaxed. And then she sang some more songs that she thought he would know. And the mother saw what was happening. She came over and started singing. That EMT sat with that little boy in the ambulance, sang all the way to the hospital, sang with him until the doctors were able to help him. And she wrote about it. It was in the Ensign. That was how I learned about it. And she said what a blessing it was to be prompted by Heavenly Father to do the right thing for that little 4-year-old. And what a blessing for that little 4-year-old that somebody knew the song that he would love that would help him. So I think music does fulfill its purpose. It inspires us at conference. You've been to a baptismal service, you have felt the calming influence while you're waiting that long time for them to change their clothes. Far firesides, funerals, I hear organ prayed in the temple. When I go to the Jordan River Temple, there's one little lady that knows who I am, and the minute I walk in, she starts playing the hearts of the children on the organ, and it just tickles me to pieces. Anyway, I have been richly blessed. And the book is as it was intended to be. I can vouch for that. Now, music also helps us to understand. Or it's supposed to help us understand. Here's some more quotes. Sometimes you just need somebody else to say what you already believe. Okay, so we did feel. Let's see now. Music can help us to understand through the Spirit. I will sing with the Spirit, and I will sing with the understanding also. The understanding part is where we have trouble sometimes. We can get through a song, but that's different than understanding it. Okay, so somebody's videoing me. I hope you can hear me. I apologize. Okay, primary children are not too young to understand, especially nursery-age children respond to music and can remember and feel and understand the Spirit through music long before they can visualize things. Look at these two little ones. Look at the faces. You know, one's a mommy, one's a daddy. I mean, that's obvious. And one of my little cute piano students said, I love our primary songs. They help me feel Heavenly Father-like. So you are the primary music leader, and you do have great influence. But here's the challenge. How to be effective in your calling. Eliza R. Snow, right from the beginning, when she went around as a Relief Society general president, organizing primaries in all the outlying wards and branches, she said the problem always was finding women who related to children and had the capacity for teaching them. Lay women, that's the difference. We are lay, all of us in here, we are lay. Everything I know how to do, I learned because I said yes to a primary, or to a music, start over. Everything I know how to do, I learned how to do through a calling I was given. They don't call you because you know. They call you because they think you're willing to learn. So thank you, now we know why we're here. Okay, here's what you have to teach this year, the outline for 2013. How many do not have a second meeting program yet? Oh my gosh, you are good. Then you already know this. But this is pretty skinny compared to some years. Some you've already taught. I'm a child of God. My Heavenly Father loves me. Families can be together forever. Probably a child's prayer. So really, as far as new material, you don't have a lot to learn. How many do not know if the singer stood beside me? Well, see, we're good. Most everybody has had exposure to these songs. Now, the songs that are chosen have to be, yes?
I've been here for 3 years,
uh-huh.
And really the only one that's new to me, old to me, is When I'm Baptized.
Uh-huh.
So they're all pretty new to me this year, and I've really been doing this for 3 years.
Okay, so who has been here 3 years or less in the calling?
Well, they don't know these songs.
Okay. Who has been longer than 3 years? Okay, so we're about halfway. All right, here's what happens. This is the short version of the primary songbook. This is what gets translated. So if you look, it doesn't have, where's the picture? Pictures are like this. They're not in color, two page, and it's a short list because of the expanse. So a lot of them go to countries that don't have huge population. However, it is translated into Spanish, which is surprising, and perhaps soon that will be done completely. But at any rate, they have to choose for the second meeting program from the short list. So that's why you see some recycling. But it doesn't matter that you might want to choose something that teaches the same message to supplement that. But they can't suggest those in the sacrament meeting program because they won't be available worldwide, you see? So if you feel like it's, you know, squished and kind of running from a small track, there's one up here and one up here in the front. At any rate, that's the reasoning on it. So here are the other songs. I call them support songs. I went through the whole program and identified everything when it says song. And you can do the same. It's in, I can't leave this up forever. But these are the other